The gut microbiota is one of the densely populated ecosystems that is highly adapted and personalized. There are more than 10 trillion bacteria in the gut microbiota. There is crosstalk between the gut microbiota and the mucosal immune system, which helps in the homeostasis of the immune system of the individual. During first 2 to 3 years of life, there is high changes in the gut microbiota, which gradually increases in population and establishes, ultimately result in a highly adapted, personalized gut microbiota system for the individual. Different factors influences the gut microbiota, such as mode of delivery, type of food that the child gets, as well as the environmental factors. Environmental factors such as high fat diet, high carbohydrate diet would influence the gut microbiota, leading to dysbiosis. If there is improper gut microbiota, that can lead to the development of long-standing illnesses like obesity, diabetes mellitus, and even cardiovascular diseases. Therefore, in order to prevent non-communicable diseases, a healthy gut microbiota is essential. We have to make sure that the proper diet and proper food items are given to the individual in order to enhance the development of a healthy gut microbiota, which will help in establishing a proper healthy immune system and thus help in the early programming of the individual, preventing the development of different non-communicable diseases later in life. Probiotics are microorganisms, when administered in adequate quantities, will confer health benefits to the individual. Microorganisms belonging to the genera Lactobacillus and Bifidobacteria are the commonly used two groups of probiotics. The probiotics act at three different levels in the individual host. In level 1, it interacts with the intestinal luminal microorganisms and creates a healthy micro ecosystem within the gut. The second level is at the mucosal level or the epithelial level. It helps in establishing a healthy epithelium and the mucosal system, thus strengthening the gut mucosal immune barrier in the individual. The third level is at a distant level in the organs of the body other than the intestines, such as the liver, as well as sometimes it affects in the brain as well. Therefore, provision of probiotics will help confer health benefits to an individual who has effects of dysbiosis caused by other organisms in the gut of the individual. Increase adiposity, reduce beta cell function, systemic inflammation, oxidative stress, metabolic endotoxemia, all are linked to the dysbiosis in the gut, or unhealthy gut microbiota can lead to the development of these states, which in return will contribute to the development of certain non-communicable diseases such as diabetes or cardiovascular diseases. However, one thing we should bear in mind is that all microorganisms does not confer all the favorable effects that probiotics as a whole confer on the individual. In order to prevent certain identifiable diseases, we have to have identified what is the best microorganism or the best probiotic that would help in preventing a certain kind of illness. Probiotics will also help in invasive diarrheas, where they will compete with the other organisms, improve the dysbiosis that they have brought about into the gut ecosystem, as well as improve the gut immune function, thus reducing the effect of diarrheal illness on the gut and overall morbidity and mortality that could lead to diarrheal illnesses on an individual. Therefore, we can see that probiotics has an effect on acute illnesses as well as it has a favorable effect on the prevention of some of the long-term chronic illnesses such as diabetes and cardiovascular diseases.